I have 3 kids, 1 in heaven, 2 here. And I love all my kids equally. But Gavin was something special. He was unbelievably spiritual for being 5 years old. He was the kid who stood up for the weaker kid. The morning he passed away, we woke up and he was in our bed. And his mom said, Gavin, what are you doing? Why are you sleeping in your bed? You have to sleep in your big boy bed. And he said, Mom, don't ask me. God makes my decisions for me. And he would have been an awesome man. I know it. It was a Friday. It was April 8th. I remember it was sunny. We had to go and get a birthday present for a friend of ours. My daughter, who was 15 at the time, was home, and she was going to do some housework and chores, and my youngest daughter was doing homework. We were going to take Gavin with us, and they said, you know what, just leave him here. He's having fun, he's playing, he's, you know, doing what boys do. And so we said, okay, and we left. We weren't gone for very long, and I remember we got the present, we came back, we were right down the street, not even a half mile, and we got a call from the fire department, and they said, there's been an accident and you need to come home. I couldn't get into the cul-de-sac, so I stopped the car in the middle of the road, and I just ran into the house. They wouldn't let me in, but I forced my way in, and then I just saw Gavin laying on the floor, and they were working on him. My girls were on the stairs, they were crying. Well, my 15-year-old daughter, she was the one who found her brother, and she was the one who cut him down from the cords and called 911 and shielded her sister from seeing her dead brother and gave him CPR, tried to save his life. I mean, she's a hero to me. And they took him to the hospital and they kept on working on him. It was the weirdest scene because it was all this chaos and craziness and nurses and doctors and noises and beeps and then it was silent. And then the room was empty. And I just, that was the worst day of my life. A dad's job is to protect his child. And I failed. And so I beat myself up for a long time because that's how I saw it. I just made it simple. I didn't do my job. I was pretty much non-functional. I don't remember anything the year afterwards. As a parent, you battle with guilt, you battle with grief and the depression, knowing that he's never gonna come back. All those individual struggles and obstacles, which are just huge, just huge. Just getting up every day in the morning is a struggle, you know, getting through the day. And then the anxiety of, well, there's tomorrow, you know. I never had anxiety before. I developed a lot of social anxiety. Dealing with my daughter's grief, both of them, and them grieving differently and struggling as a parent, that's hard. I think through a lot of counseling, through a lot of deep talks with friends and families and, you know, kind of grief share communities where other people have lost, I've come to realize that it's not that simple. And sometimes horrible accidents happen to good people. You know, this is one positive thing is that I ask my daughters constantly, am I a good dad? And they say, absolutely. And it makes me feel good. And I know, and I thank God for the 5 years that I had with my son. I thank God every night, believe me. And I know every day of that boy's life, I was the best dad I could be to him. It just took time for me to grow out of that simplified thinking, you know, into where I am today. I have an amazing wife. I married up. I'm way lucky. There's a grace of God that we're still married and going strong. But it wasn't easy. I think the biggest thing is communication. Losing a child and going through grief really plays a lot of tricks in your mind, you know. It really messes with you big time. And it causes resentment and anger, even to the people that are closest to you. You have to recognize that for me, my wife isn't my enemy. And what it came down to it was that I only have one person on this earth who's going through what I'm going through, and that's my wife. When I was at my very low, she was there to support me. And when she was at her very low, I was there to support her. I was fortunate to have my law enforcement family through this because they were really supportive. And I had a lot of discussions with them about my kids because they struggled a lot, especially my oldest. I sought a grief share group at a local church, and that was a game changer for me. Finding people and talking to people who have also lost and sharing stories and sharing struggles with other people and venting, and it just is so helpful. Just to have somebody to talk to that knows maybe not exactly what you're going through, but, you know, they have a good idea. You have this thing in your mind, I did, of, well, you gotta get over this soon. You have a timeline that you gotta get over. Don't. you don't have to get over it soon. Take care of yourself, take care of your family. For us, I think the positive thing is that we're matured, we have a different perspective, learning that time really does heal. After my son passed away, of course, you know, I tried to do as much research as I could, and it was amazing the number I found of kids that died from this. The biggest thing is that the more people that know and the more people that are aware of this danger, the more lives that we can save. That's why I said this is difficult for me to do. It's not like I wake up and say, you know what, I want to do this and cry on camera and you know, remember the horrible day that I lost my son. But I feel like I have to because I want people to know my story and I want people to share my story and I want others to know my story so that they can get rid of their cord blinds and make their home safe for their children. I don't want to see anybody going through what I went through. I know that I have a lot of people, family and friends, supporting me and stuff. But I also know that those same family and friends still have corded blinds in their house. All I can do is just keep spreading my story and spreading the message about the dangers of corded blinds. Every time I talk to people, every time I share my story, I know I'm saving lives. And I lost my son. Maybe that means that somebody else, you know, won't lose their child. Eliminate the dangers, and it's just better safe than sorry. Cords kill kids.